Let's learn fractions multiplication for grade 4 or P4 students. In this video, we will learn fraction multiplications of different types like fractions, unlike fractions, proper fractions, improper fractions, and mixed fractions. Some examples, and also at the end of this lesson, you will also get worksheets for you to practice. So you can download these worksheets from our blog post and you can practice by yourself. Let's start with the multiplication of two like fractions. 5 is the numerator, it is smaller than the denominator, that's why it is a proper fraction. So the both like 1 by 9 also proper fraction. So we are now multiplying two like fractions. Like means both denominators are same. 9 and 9 both are same. So that's why it is called a like fractions. So these two like fractions, let's learn how to multiply. So of multiplication, first before we start learning solving the problem, the first step is multiply the numerators from each fraction by each other. That means multiply the numerators of this one, 5 multiply by 1, we need to multiply for each number, that is a top numbers, and secondly multiply the denominators of the each fraction by each other. So that means these two numbers, the denominator numbers, need to multiply, and then the top two numerators need to multiply. Is it straightforward? For example, 5 multiply by 1, 5 multiply by 1 divided by 9 multiply by 9. So let's see here, first one, multiply the numerators of each fraction by each other, that means 5 and 1 we need to multiply. Next one, multiply the denominators of each fraction by each other, that means this 9 multiply by 9 is the we need to multiply together. That means what happens, what we will get is 5 1 ja 5, then it is 9 9 ja 81. So then the finally last step is simplify or reduce the answer if possible. So here 5 by 81, so in divide multiplication is a you will get it 80, you will not get the 81, that's why you cannot simplify further. So this is the simplest form of this fraction, so you can just leave it as it is, no need to simplify further. So this is how you can multiply two like fractions. Let's move on to the next one, multiplying two unlike fractions. So what you mean by unlike fractions is when fractions have a different denominators. So here 7 and 5 both are not the same, that's why it is called a example is a two unlike fractions. So here also the multiplication rules is same. The first one, the top numerator need to multiply each other, and the denominator denominators of the each fraction need to multiply. So here the top one is 5 and 3, and the denominator 7 and 5 is quite, it is 5 multiply by 3 and then 7 then 7 multiply by 5. So when you multiply 5 multiply by 3, you will get it 15, and then 7 multiply by 5 is 35. So again we actually solve the first step and second step. Next, the third step, simplify or reduce the answer. Let's see whether you can simplify. Both the top denominator and numerator have a 5 5, that means you can actually see multiply these two numbers with the multiplication by 5. So 5 3 is 15, Then similarly, 5 7 ja 35. So the, you will get the answer 3 by 7. 3 you cannot divide 7. So by 7 arrest, but in same multiplication number you will not get both 3 and 7. That's why this is the simplest form of this fraction. So you, this is 3 by 7 is the answer for this equation. So let's move on to next one, which is multiplying whole number with a fraction. So in this, the two in this equation, you see 2 multiply by 3 by 5. This is the fraction and this one is a whole number. So whole number, one whole number we are multiplying with another fraction. So the multiplication rules for this type of equation is also a same. So you need to multiply top two numbers and then multiply the denominators both. Okay, for example, 2 is a whole number, so you can actually, if you confuse, you can add divide 2 by 1. So 1 means any number you divide by 1, you will get the same answer. For example, 1 1 ja and 1 2 ja. So you put 1, so there is no, it won't go into effect on this whole number by 1. Then you get the, you convert this whole number into a fraction. That means 2 by 1, 3 by 5. So how to multiply? The first rule is you need to multiply the two numerators, that is these two numbers. And the second rule says multiply the two denominators, that is this and this, you need to multiply. So here, if you rewrite this equation, you will get 2 multiply by 3, then 1 multiply by 5. So answer is 2, 3 ja 6 and 1, 5 ja 5. Very simple. You see, you just added 1 to the denominator for 2 whole number. So once you add 2, then you get the 2 denominators and the 2 numerators. Otherwise, if you have a, just how to solve it, one more, another type is 2 multiply by 3, then the right below 5 as it is, because the denominator for this number, if nothing is there, just leave it, then you can directly solve 2 multiply by 3 is equal to 6 divided by 5. But if you confuse, you can just always add a 1 to the whole number as a numerator, sorry, denominator, then multiply this 1 multiply by 5 and 2 multiply by 3, then you can solve the equation. So let's move on to the next type, which is one mixed number and one another is a fraction. So this is the fraction and this is the mixed number. So let's start how to solve this equation. And before solving this equation, let's read the multiplication rules. When multiplying a mixed numbers, you need to change the mixed number into a improper fraction before you multiply. So you need to remember always this sentence. So what you need to do, first step is you need to convert mixed number into a improper fraction. So in this case, we have a 2, 4 by 5 is the mixed fraction. We need to convert this into improper fraction. So let's rewrite this right as it is, 2 by 9, then multiply by. So how to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction? We just multiply 5 by 2, 5 multiply by 2, then need to add the new plus addition of the numerator, that is 4. So then you write the denominator as it is, that is 5. So now what you will get it, 5 multiplied by 2 is 10, then plus 4. So 10 plus 4 is equal to 14. Let's rewrite this equation one more time. 2 by 9 multiplied by 14 by 5. Now we actually converted the mixed number to a improper fraction. What is improper fraction? We already learned improper fraction is numerator is greater than the denominator. Here you see the numerator is greater than the denominator. That is called, that's why it is a improper fraction. In the first exam, first one, first fraction 2 by 9, this 2 is smaller than the denominator, that's why it is a proper fraction. So now let's apply the second rule, that is multiply the numerators. From this step onwards it is the same, we need to multiply the two numerators and then the two denominators in order to find the, in order to get the answer. That is 2 multiply by 14, that is these two numbers, then multiply these two numbers, that is denominator 9 multiply by 5, 14 to the 28, then 9 5 the 45. So you can you need to simplify. You see, next step is simplify or reduce the answer. So either you can keep it, if you can solve it further, divide these two numbers, you can divide it. If not, you just keep it as it is. So for 28 by 45, this is the answer for this problem. So you will learn now, just now, one proper fraction multiplying a another mixed number. So mixed number, first step you always convert into a improper fraction, then start multiplying it. Let's learn the next one. It is multiplying two mixed numbers. So it is same, just now what we learn is mixed number. Now we just need to convert both mixed numbers to a improper fractions, then multiply both of them. Let's learn 5, 6, 6 multiply by 5, rewriting, converting into mixed number, improper fraction, plus 5. How it is? It is 6 multiply by 5, then plus 5. So then divide by 6 as it is, then multiply symbol, this symbol as it is. Then now 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, then plus 2, then divide by 3. So now 6, 5, 30, plus 5, 35. 35 divide by 6, multiply, next 3, 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8. 8 divided by 3. Now you need to multiply 35 by 8, that is 35 multiply by 8 divide by 6, 3 is 18. So you can actually multiply 35 by 8 by 18, or else if you can simplify now itself, instead of making this whole 30 numbers together as one big number and then start dividing, you can actually start dividing now itself. How it is, if you can check whether you can any numbers you can divide. So for example, if 8 and 18 is here, 2 4 ja 8, 2 9 ja 18. So you are already reducing these numbers to a smaller number instead of multiplying 35 by 8 and then divide that number with 18. So here it is again, you can multiply this and this, that is check whether you can get it 35 in a 9 multiplication. You cannot get it because it is 9 5 is a 45. So it is a 35 by here. So now you have to do is 35 multiply by 4 by 9. So how to multiply by 35 by 4? If you don't know, you can just write it separately. 35 by multiply by 4, that is 4 5 is a 20 to carry forward. So 4 3 is a 12 plus 2, 14, that is 140. You will get it 140 divided by 9 is the answer for this equation here. So you know already how to solve two mixed fractions. Now it is a time for you guys to practice this simple multiplication problems. So here in these next few pages we actually listed down few exam practice questions. You can solve this by then you can learn, and if you do not know anything you can actually always contact me. I will try to explain you any kind of problems if you have in multiplication fractions. So thank you for watching this video.